I'm Luke Summer here. Today, we're going to talk about how smartphones zoom in on their subject. Many smartphones nowadays can zoom in up to 2, 3, even 10 times, right? But how does it work? Well, let's talk about it. But first, as usual, if you learn something new, if I can make you chuckle before the end of this video, if you like how I'm rocking, or if you just like my vibe, then go ahead, like, and subscribe. If I get it, hit the bell icon too to turn those notifications away. Ding. You know when to upload something new. Now let's get into it. So, before optical zooms, digital zoom used to be the way that smartphones always zoomed in, which is perfectly fine. Now, the way digital zoom works is it mimics optical zoom. Digital zoom basically does a crop of what you're looking at. So it crops in on the subject that you're trying to capture. It cuts off some of the areas around what you're looking at. And doing this makes the subject look closer. And this seems like a great way to get closer to your subject without actually having to physically move closer. However, digital zoom does not retain the sharpness of the subject before zooming. Digital zoom is not lossless, and this just means that some of the information the camera is capturing about the subject gets discarded. This results in some blurry looking photos, which, depending on how close you zoomed in using digital zoom, could be either decent for social media or absolutely terrible that you don't want to share. Now think of digital zooming as you take a picture of something far away and then you edit manually to crop in on the picture. It's basically what's happening, it's just automatic for you. Now digital zoom is what phones used to use prior to optical zoom being the norm in smartphones. So let's see how optical zoom works. Optical zooming works by using multiple lens elements. This isn't cropping the photo. The actual lens itself is magnifying closer to the subject. Now as a result, you're not losing quality. That would make optical zoom lossless. See what they did there? Compared to digital zooming. Now, some of you may be wondering, how do smartphones achieve this optical zooming without a bigger camera bump similar to dedicated cameras? You see, modern day smartphones have a periscope lens setup. Basically, there are multiple lenses inside the phone. These lenses allow for multiple zoom levels to be achieved. The phone just chooses which camera has the higher magnification factor for what you want, hence the multiple cameras on the back of our phones. And of course, as smart and impactful technology as modern smartphones are, both optical zoom and digital zoom do get combined, which is not a surprise at all. This is called hybrid zoom, which also isn't surprising, nor is it really creative. But this approach uses optical, digital, and computational algorithms to get you the best possible picture no matter what. See, optical zoom for a lot of phones can top out at 10 times zoom. Going beyond that is when digital zoom kicks in. Now, as we talked about earlier, digital zoom causes a deterioration of quality, but that is where the computational algorithms kick in and work in tandem with the digital zoom. Computational algorithms have allowed generations of smartphones to take pictures that hit way above their specifications. The first and second generation Google Pixel phones come to mind because they were able to take portrait shots with only a single lens. All thanks to computational algorithms. Not bad. Now, these same algorithms can sharpen what you see in the scene when you zoom in via digital zoom. Now, this isn't as good as optical zoom, but it is pretty clutch when you want to get something that is 20, 30, or even 100 times away. Looking at you, Samsung. Either way, it's pretty dang impressive. But that brings us to the end of this video. As usual, I made you chuckle before the end of this video. If you learned something new, if you like how I'm rocking, or if you just like my vibe, then go ahead, like, subscribe. And while you at it, hit the bell icon too to turn the notifications away. Thing you know when to upload something new. And please leave comments down below. That way I can improve and make better content for you guys. Other than that, this has been Normal Consumer, and I'll see you guys in the next one.